Welcome to our celebration of the Holy Sacrifice of Mass. We stand and face in our thanks to our sister Viola as we begin this Mass on her behalf, which is the prayer of Jesus Christ himself. This is a prayer for our sister, and it's a prayer of Jesus, so we begin all prayers in the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen. The Lord be with you. Brothers and sisters, in the waters of baptism, Viola died with Christ and rose with him to new life. May she now share with him the eternal glory. We now place over our sister's body the pall, the outer garment, reminding the Father of his promise to her at her baptism. Candle place over the crucifix, which is the portal, the gateway for each one of us, into the heart of the Father. Lastly, the candle place over the hope of the gospel, the good news, the joy and the handmaid of your life. We begin this Mass, the celebration of the life lived in Christ, by singing together our opening song.
Please join us in singing number 650 on Eagle's Wings. Number 650.
They shall judge nations and rule over peoples, and the Lord shall be their Those who trust in him shall understand truth, and faithful shall abide in him one, because grace and mercy are with his holy ones, and his care is with his elect. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Redemption.
Jesus said to the crowds, "Everything that the Father gives me will come to me, and I will not reject anyone who comes to me, because I came down from heaven not to do my own will, but the will of the one who sent me. And this is the will of the one who sent me, that I should not lose anything of what he gave me, but that I should raise it on the last day. For this is the will of my Father, that everyone who sees the Son and believes in him may have eternal life, and I shall raise him on the last day." The Gospel of the Lord.
We cry, Abba, Father. And there again,
We are adopted into the Holy Trinity, God the Father, God the Son, and God the Holy Spirit. And we, as children of God, can cry out, Abba, Father. Doesn't matter what our earthly fathers were or are. We have a Father in heaven who is just so madly in love with us. He wants the best for us. We are children of God, and if children, then heirs. Heirs of God and joint heirs with Christ. So we, again, are incorporated into the beautiful family of God and into the Catholic Church, the community of worship that we can call our family. All of this through our baptism. Then it says, if only we suffer with him, so that we may also be glorified with him. That's the part we want to avoid. I do. I don't like pain. But with pain, we see a little bit of a glimpse of what Jesus did for us in suffering and dying on the cross. If you want to start complaining about yourself, just think of what Jesus suffered. His scourging at the pillar. First of all, his agony in the garden, his sweat of blood. The scourging at the pillar, the crowning of thorns, the carrying of the cross, nailing to the cross. All because he loves us so much. So as much as he loves Paul, who is not dead but alive, he loves us. So this service is also very much for us. We need to be reminded that one day we'll die, and then we will meet God. We'll meet Jesus. Will we be ready? So we wait in eager expectation for the revelation of the children of God. And looking at Viola's life, I'm trying to remember so many things, and I really thought it was ironic that she kind of went full circle. Born in Sarpy County in Omaha, Iowa, and then somehow with 4-H and showing cattle, running to this guy named Marvin. And I understand she came to the Catholic Church. She was not a born Catholic. And so then in the West Point area, she didn't stick around too long because they went to Clarkson and bought a farm there. And farmed by Clarkson for so many years. And then had a little stint in Norfolk, which didn't seem to go too well. And they ended up back on a farm by Wisner. Farming is in the blood. And then retiring in Fremont, and Uncle Marvin passing away in Iowa, back to Omaha. That's a beautiful circle of life. And it's funny, the things I remember about Viola. I remember once she told me she dresses up in a Chevy pickup, ran on propane, and she would wear a farmer's man's hat and coat. And I said, why? And she said, well, that way I won't be assaulted because they'll think I'm a man and they won't attack me. Just things like that. And just, I got the opportunity to go and help Marvin Viola chop silage and make that file silage and go ahead and add to be just so. And just enjoy the evenings when we had supper. And I remember as a kid in was some kind of like exotic meat. We ate it and then we found out it was either a rabbit or a squirrel or some crazy animal. Which, maybe we wouldn't have ate it. But just beautiful memories, especially at the farm. My sister Diane was not able to make it today, and just saw that she had different memories. She had memories of the little pony that we'd go and we'd ride, and that pony would buck us off. And she said, Viola always gave her good advice when she started her family. Viola was telling her how to buy a train, how to remedy these illnesses. She was always one pretty holistic, homemade remedies, and some of them I will admit I was a little afraid to try. But that was Viola. And she would be involved in real estate, she would be involved in selling those crazy chairs at the state fair, and spend that whole long time at the state fair. But the thing to remember about Viola is that she had such a big, hard, tender, loving, always caring for the other, always caring for us, always wanting to please us. And then in her later years, her companion was her favorite cat. And she just, I don't think there was a mean bone in her body. She was just gentle as a good earth. That's the way I picture Viola. And I think that's how God looks at her. And in this Gospel of John, everything that the Father gives me will come to me. I will not reject anyone who comes to me. The Viola is brought to him and is worthy, he will not reject her, because he came by his Father's will to earth, Jesus did, to save us and to not let any of us be lost. It would break his heart that we would be lost. That's the example we have today with Viola's life, that we need to reflect on our own life. It was the will of Jesus, the one who sent him, that he should not lose anything of what he gave him, but should raise it on the last day. You may have heard what I'm talking, that I'm kind of placing Viola in heaven, but I'm saying we aren't the judge, we don't know. So I would say Viola would be out to us, please continue praying for me. And that's what we ask too. Continue to pray for this beautiful soul of Viola. God bless you.
Brothers and sisters, Jesus Christ is risen from the dead and sits at the right hand of the Father, who intercedes for his church. Confident that God hears the voice of those who trust in the Lord Jesus, we now join our prayers to his.
For Viola, may she comforted in our grief and strengthened by our faith in Christ. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For those who suffer pain in mind or body, may they never feel alone. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For those who have gone before us, especially by love, that they may rest peacefully in Christ, their eternal home. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the needs of our own hearts today, may we be comforted by an outpouring of the Holy Spirit. We pray to the Lord.
Lord,
for the petitions we hold in silence of our hearts, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Lord God, giver of peace, healer of our souls, hear the prayers of your name of Jesus Christ and the voices of your people whose lives are purchased by the blood of the Lamb. Forgive the sins of all who sleep in Christ and grant them a place in your kingdom. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Please be seated as we prepare the altar. Pray, brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. As we humbly present to you the sacrificial offering of the Lord, the salvation of your servant Viola, we beseech your mercy that she who did not doubt your Son to be a loving Savior may find in him a merciful judge who lives and reigns forever and ever.
Placed now on the altar are Sister Viola, daughter of the Father. And place your memories on the altar, your desire for her, for her family right now. So when I elevate the host, I will give the chalice. It's your heart, it's your memory of Viola, and it's Viola herself that we're raising up in the heart of the Father with this mass. The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. For he is the salvation of the world, the life of the human race, the resurrection of the dead. Through him, the hosts of angels adore your majesty and rejoice in your presence forever. May our voices, we pray, join with theirs, one chorus of exalted praise.
Filled with His Holy Spirit, may become one body, one
one spirit in Christ. May he make of us an eternal offering to you, so that we may obtain an inheritance with your elect, especially with most blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, blessed Joseph, her spouse, with your blessed apostles and glorious martyrs, and with all the saints in whose constant intercession in your presence we rely on faith and help. May this sacrifice of our reconciliation, we pray, O Lord, in advance of peace and salvation of all the world, be pleased to confirm in faith and charity your pilgrim church on earth with your servant Francis, our Pope, George, our bishop, the order of bishops, all the clergy, and the entire people you have named for your own. Listen graciously to the prayers of this family whom you have summoned for you. In your compassion, merciful Father, gather yourself all your children scattered throughout the world. Remember your servant, Viola, whom you have called from this world to yourself. Grant that she who is united to her Son in a death like his may also be one with him in his resurrection. When from the earth you will raise up in the flesh those who have died and transform our holy body after the pattern of his own glorious body. To our departed brothers and sisters, too, and to all who are pleasing to you at the passing of this life, give kind admittance to your kingdom. There we hope to enjoy forever the fullness of your glory, when you will wipe away every tear from our eyes. For seeing you, our God, as you are, we shall be like you from all the ages, and praise you at that end, through Christ our Lord, to whom we still own the world. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
Amen.
Please stand. The Savior's command, informed by my teaching, we now dare to say, pray for our sister in the words our Savior taught us. We pray, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant us peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom of God.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but the faith of the church, and graciously grant our peace and unity in accordance with your will, live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
Peace, O Lord, be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer each other the sign of peace.
Thank you.
For things now in divine community too, at a Mass, the dead are Mass for funeral Mass from Loyola, is if you're going to receive the Eucharist today, offer the grace of the Eucharist out for Loyola, the needs of her soul this day, that she indeed be received completely in that room that God has prepared for her at the foundation of the world. If you're not able to receive the Eucharist, would like to receive the blessing, the deacon and myself will be here to serve. And if you simply come forward and say, put your hand like this in the Eucharist, just cross yourself with this, and we can give you a blessing on your behalf, but also on behalf of my own and our family.
Please join us in singing number 550, Prayer of St. Francis, number 550.
Thank you.
Take a moment to thank God for the gift of the Eucharist, whether you physically or spiritually receive today. We each receive that blessing. Now consider first your favorite image of Jesus. Maybe you've seen the image of divine mercy with grace and mercy emanating from his heart. Maybe he's a good shepherd. Maybe the agony of the garden. Maybe the last one, Jesus. Now, in light of that image of your Savior, think of Viola. Think of one memory you have of her, one word for you that will define or encapsulate her personality, her gentleness, her kindness, whatever it is, consider that word. Thank Jesus for a witness to you of his love for you and the world. And in your heart, you say, Jesus, I surrender my will to you. Let us pray. Lord God, whose Son left us in the sacrament of his body, food for the journey, mercifully grant that strengthened by it, our sister Viola may come to the eternal table of Christ in this reign forever and ever. Amen. Please be seated now. We ask our standing to come forward and say a few words.
She recalled waiting in ration lines to get extra food for the family with the
they got married. They were married when she was 21 at St. Bridget's Church in Omaha on January 16th of 1946. Then we get to book two. And book two was named Pioneer Days. So they moved on to one of the Dornemann farms around West Point. And according to her, they were stuck up in the hills away from people, and they really had to work hard so they could get the harvest up. And if you wanted water, you had to go outside and pump it yourself. Keeping in mind, she'd been living in Omaha with running water and bathrooms for a while, so going back to the farm was a rude awakening. She shot squirrels, deer, rabbits, and other varmints that got in her way. It sounds like the deacon was telling us sometimes they ended up on the table. She sold eggs from her in-laws for 25 cents a dozen. They lived on a shoestring, and if they had 50 cents left at the end of the week, they would splurge and go to town for a meal. Ultimately, Ken came to live with them as their son when he was 2 years old, and 2 years later, their daughter Judy arrived. Ken now has 3 girls and 2 grandchildren, and Judy has 2 girls and 1 boy. So they farmed for years and years, and those are the memories that I have. My dad is Ken Moss, and he is oldest grandchild of her brother Jaime. And my mom's parents lived in Norfolk, so we used to drive up through and see the Dornemanns all the time. And it was a rare treat for this city girl to get to go, you know, gather eggs. There was always food. I do remember the chairs, because we could try out all the chairs. And there's something about, did she have plastic on her couches? It's a memory I have, because she didn't want them to get dirty from everything on the farm. But she always had food, and when my dad would turn off onto 91 instead of going straight into Norfolk, we would all get really excited in the back seat. So that was really lots of fun. So, we have talked about the Pioneer Days. Then we get to book three, and she never really had a name for that one until she was moved back to Omaha. At age 94, 95, she decided that that became the golden years. She loved cats, and for many years she had birds. And one of the last things that I saw in her notes for her funeral was make sure that Katie's ashes come with me in my casket. So I called Ken to say, oh, I just found this note. He goes, don't worry about it. The last 3 cats' ashes are joining Viola, and she makes her journey to heaven. Ultimately, they did sell their farm at Clarkson and moved to Norfolk to retire. However, after they moved to Norfolk, she went back to school and got a real estate license. Unfortunately, she only sold one house, her own. After they sold the house in Norfolk, they bought a farm in Wisner and farmed for several more years before finally moving to Fremont, Nebraska. She continued to live on her own with her 9 lives as she struggled with health issues for numerous years. She was able to stay in her home because Ken took such great care of her, and her neighbor Dawn took such great care of her. Finally, she got to the point where she needed to move to assisted living, and she made the decision to sell her home in Fremont and return to her birthplace of Sarpy County, Nebraska, closer to my dad and his uncles, and to take some pressure off of Ken and the daily drugs he was. So she lived happily in Mabel Rose assisted living until she fell and broke her arm, and then unfortunately she ended up moving to memory care, which was not great, but the best thing about Viola is she never ever forgot her memories and the stories. And so most of the stories you've heard would be me being visiting with her and making notes on my iPhone. So writing this eulogy, all I could do is go back through my notes and find out she did. Most recently, they never could get Viola to sit. All of you who know her know she doesn't sit. So she was still tuning around at 97 on her walk. One of the few people at her living place that was like that. They kept telling Ken and I that maybe we should try to let venture. And Ken and I said, we try. Good luck with that. And so she did fall a few weeks ago, which kind of led to her ultimate. But for the last year or so, she's told me on several occasions, I know God has something for me to do still, because I'm still here. but I sure hope I do it soon, because I'm getting lonesome and I'm ready to go. So I mourn her today, but I also know that she's missed Marvin terribly, and that her faith in God, and she's sitting up there and during service this Sunday. So I always with us today.
Before we go our separate ways, let us take leave of our sister, Viola, and may our farewell express our affection for her. May it ease our sadness and strengthen our hope. One day, we shall joyously greet her again with the love of Christ, which conquers all things, destroys even death.
And go to what's called delay.